morning, everyone. It's Elaine from Anabella's. Welcome back to FlossTube 151. I am filming from home today. This is the hen den that I'm sitting in right now, my favorite room in the house. We have solid ice outside again today. I was able to get to the shop yesterday for a little bit, but I left all my stuff there, so I don't have any models or anything to show you, but I do have a lot to share today. If you're new to my channel, welcome. This channel is primarily about cross stitching, quilting, and paper crafting with a little bit of my life thrown in every now and then. And if you're returning, thank you so much for coming back. Thank you for all of your comments and for all of your emails and your telephone calls and your engagement with us. I really, really appreciate all of you. Thanks for connecting with us on social media, for subscribing to this channel, and for ringing that notification bell. That'll let you know when I've uploaded a new video or I have some fun news to share. So I hope everybody had a great week. We've just been inundated where Terry and I live in Maggie Valley, North Carolina, with snow. So a little bit of history lesson here. Maggie Valley is in a valley in the Smoky Mountains, and we live at 4,300 or 4,500 feet. So when Maggie Valley and Waynesville, North Carolina, where the shop is, has a forecast for snow, they may get an inch or flurries, whereas where we are, we may get, like we did this past week, a foot. So you know, we weren't expecting it. We didn't think that we'd get ice on top of it, so it's been very, very treacherous, and we've already had two accidents in our lifetime coming up and down our mountain, one with kids in the car. So we don't go out and try to drive with ice. Terry drove us to the shop yesterday, and I didn't want to drive, so I went in his car, and it was scary. Even with him driving, there were some really rough, scary patches. And woke up this morning after everything had kind of thawed yesterday a little bit, and went out onto the porch right out here, and it is solid ice. Just too dangerous, you guys. So we're expecting more snow this afternoon, evidently. It's Friday morning. I doubt we'll get to the shop tomorrow either. But it looks like things are going to really warm up next week and we can get our, you know, get our life back. It's been kind of rough. So thanks for your patience, you guys. Kathleen, our assistant, is in the shop and getting orders out and, you know, lots of updates that I'll share with you in just a little bit about what's going on behind the scenes. okay, so let's see, what else did we do? So we were stranded, and Terry, who you guys may not know, is a self-taught chef. He is phenomenal, and he makes some of the best dishes you could ever imagine. And when we were here over the weekend, he made a tray of lasagna. I am telling you, it was the best lasagna I ever had. And we were joking because when I cook, I always make enough for an army. I don't split recipes in half. And he split the lasagna recipe in half, and he took, I call it my brownie dish. It's my, you know, glass baking jar, my glass baking dish, you know, the small one that you would put brownies in or potatoes or whatever. Anyway, he put the lasagna in that, so he was able to layer three strips of the noodles and then, you know, layer it up and make the lasagna, and it was a perfect serving. So we had that one night, and then we had it the next day too. And it was phenomenal. So that was it. You know, I did a lot of stitching over the weekend, and he watched a lot of football. His Bills won, so we're really happy about that. My Dolphins lost, not so happy about that. But this Sunday is a huge game with Buffalo and Kansas City, and he is from Buffalo, as am I, originally. So it's going to be great because I love Kansas City because I love the quarterback, wink, wink. Even though he could be my son, right? His age, Patrick Mahomes, if I'm saying that right. So Sunday's going to be fun around here. So we'll see how that goes. All right. So let's see. Let's talk some cross stitch. That's why you're all here, to have some stitchy time. Some new releases from Anabella's. And like I said, I left everything at the shop. He was rushing me out yesterday. You know, it was 4 o'clock on the dot, and the man has got the dogs gathered up. Chloe's in her car seat, and he's ready to walk out the door. And I still, you know, haven't even gotten my thoughts together yet on what I'm going to do for FlossTube. And I ended up going out the door and leaving everything there. So I don't have the models to show you. I'll show them to you next week. But we do have two new releases by Anabella's Needle Art. And if you are new to my channel, my daughter and I started designing a couple years ago. And every now and again, we release new charts, and I like to share them with you here. So the first one is our Tiny Houses February. I'm going to stick this back in again, even though this is a re-release. I mean, this was already released. This is our Tiny Houses February, because everybody wants to live in a tiny house, or I do. But like I said, I couldn't fit the hen den in my tiny house. And here is our brand new January release. So we kind of did things a little bit backwards. February came out first, now January's out, and January, February, March and April I'm working on. But aren't these adorable? This is adorable. I absolutely had so much fun stitching this over my entrapment here in the house. Love these colors, love the blues. I stitched this on a nice 14 count vintage country mocha. I just love the way the white just pops on here. And finished it off yesterday. That's why I ran into the shop. Finished it off on our antique white 5x5 Bella board. So our Bella boards are really fun. If you go to this listing in the Etsy shop, when you look at the drop-down box, you'll have the option of adding the Bella board to your cart and the floss pack. So we have both. And this is fun. So that's available now. And then the next release that we have is a new series called Birds of a Feather. So this is really fun. My daughter did most of the designing on this piece. I have to tell you, she did a beautiful job on this. And this I finished off into a really pretty pillow. And I love the lace trim that I had. It's kind of like a burlap trim. I had this in my stash in my studio. So I used this, and the fabric is from I Love Us, the fabric collection that's been out for Valentine's Day. We might have some left in the shop, but I'm not sure. I think we do. I think we have a few Bella bundles left of the fabric called I Love Us Bella bundle that we curated for you. So you could find that in the Etsy shop. And I used the same pink and cream colored fabric on the front. I finished it off on the back. And then I adhered a little piece of 2x2 inch blue wool felt square. And I put a matching little heart button, the wood button that you see here. And these wood buttons I love. They come with holes because they're buttons, but I always take a piece of embroidery floss and just kind of thread it through the buttonholes and you know, glue it real tiny on the back. And then I can use that button right on my cross stitch piece or on the back, you know, to cover up my hole on my felt. So anyway, I love these. You can expect that the January Birds of a Feather will come out probably in the next week or so. It's already done. It's finished, but I can't release it yet. I have to wait another week or two before I can release that. So January will come out, and then you'll have February and January, and then this will be a monthly series. And I think these finish off at 5x5, so it's not very large. Okay, I have some new arrivals in the shop, and the first is a new designer, and I'm not going to name all of her charts right here. What I'm going to do is pause for just a minute, and then I'm going to put in a very quick slideshow of all the new charts that we are now carrying by Emily Call. Emily Call Designs is a designer that I have been following since she pretty much got started a couple years ago, if I'm not mistaken. And I'm just thrilled that we're able to carry those charts that she does offer for wholesale right here in our Etsy shop and on our website. So enjoy these. They're beautiful. Aren't those gorgeous, you guys? I just love her. I'm really looking forward to carrying more of her designs as they become available to us shop owners. And then yesterday, Blackbird Designs, Hoffman's, one of our distributors, re-released Winter Wonderland. And this is a reprint of a Blackbird Designs chart that came out, you know, years ago, but it is reprinted. So it is absolutely beautiful. I ordered quite a few, but these kind of go fast. So if you think this would be something you'd like to stitch, you might want to go ahead and grab it or add it to your cart. This is only in the Etsy shop. And then Scattered Seed Samplings came out with this beautiful new chart. I think this came out in the past, but Hoffman's just had it yesterday. So I ordered a bunch of these. It is called Forget Me Not. And I just love this blue bird. The coloring on this is just fabulous. So that is Forget Me Not. Stitches by Ethel did a really cute Valentine tin trio. So these are three little Valentine charts that fit into these tiny candle tins that are available. And then we have Crafty Blue Bonnet. She is another fairly new designer to our shop, but if you've been following her and following the releases that I show you when they come out, she's really started this great series. It's called her spools. And she does these fabulous designs using a spool pretty much as her backdrop, backing, and then she designs right on top of that. So here is her sewing spool trio. Love these colors. Again, I'm a big fan. You know, pink obviously is my color, but I love blue is my second favorite color. So I really, really like this. This is her sewing spool trio. And then this is Let It Snow. So this is kind of like a little sampler. Love this. And then there's two more charts that she also came out with, but I don't have them here. You can look in the Etsy shop and find them there. Just go ahead and search for Crafty Blue Bonnet Designs. Then Stephanie and Lindy Stitches came out with two new charts. Here is her rose-breasted cockatoo, which I absolutely fell in love with. Back in the day, before I got my bird, Bella Fiorella, I had a cockatoo, and her name was Sarah. And when I lost Sarah, I was thinking about getting a rose-breasted cockatoo, but my husband would have divorced me. So instead, I got Bella, and he wasn't happy with her either. He's still not happy with her. But I just fell in love with this. So be sure to check Lindy's rose-breasted cockatoo out. And then she also came out with Snack Bar, and this is just so cute. Look at these two little bears. So that's Snack Bar. And then Shannon and Christine, Evergreen Forest, is new, and this is stunning. Isn't this beautiful? A very popular chart. You can grab that. Jardin Privé came out with a new medallion sampler, so I'm inserting it here. Sorry I don't have these things to show you today, you guys. I'm so sorry. I won't let him rush me next time, honestly. I can't get my stuff. And then Les Petites, we have three new charts that came out from Les Petites. I love this one. This is Love Penguin. And then they also came out with Be Mine and Happy Valentine's Day. So those are three new Valentine's charts from Les Petites. And I'm sure we have a lot of other new things that have come out. So I'm going to just direct you to the newsletter that will go out later today. If you've not signed up for the newsletter, you guys, I cannot encourage you enough. The link is below, or you can just go to anabellasshop.anabellas.net. And if you go to anabellas.net, then go to the blog, and on the right-hand side is the newsletter sign up, or you can just click the link below. Okay, now I'm going to tell you, oh, I forgot to tell you about weeks. So we carry the entire Fancy Floss for Classic Colorworks, and we also now have the entire collection of Weeks Dye Works. Now, in the Etsy shop, Classic Colorworks is listed individually, okay? But with Weeks Dye Works, I did not list each skein individually. I listed them alphabetically. So whenever you are looking at a chart for Weeks Dye Works, it 9 times out of 10, the color is shown. So if you go to the search bar and you just type in the color, it should pop up. Or you can just type in Weeks Dye Works, and it's very easy to see the letters as I've separated them. But I did want to let you know, because I know a lot of you love Weeks Dye Works. So now you can get it at Anabella's. Okay, let me talk to you now a little bit about Nashville. So our Facebook group for Nashville is now closed, but that doesn't mean that you can't, you know, participate in placing pre-orders and doing all those things with Anabella's at anabellas.net or in the Etsy shop. You can pick whatever platform you're most comfortable with, and you can shop with us on either platform. Now, this past week, in case you missed it, I did have some new pre-orders become available. There's three charts from Sampler and Primitives, which I'm not going to insert here because they're on the Etsy shop as soon as you go there, and they're on the website. But what I will tell you right now is I'm going to insert a photo here, is Atomic Ranch or Rogue Fabrics came out with their spring 4-pack, okay? These colors are absolutely beautiful. Just look at this spring 4-pack. So what we've done is we're offering this 4-pack in every count that they offer it by the fat quarter, okay? The thing is, the deadline that we have to get our order into them is January 30th. So if you want to purchase one of these spring 4-packs, please do so as soon as you can. I have to place my pre-order with them no later than November 30th to pick up your order in Nashville. Terry and I are taking 2 cars, so you know, we'll have plenty of room to bring everything back, but I want to make sure that you get to pick out the spring 4-pack of your choice. Now, the counts are 14, 16, 18, 20, 28, 32, 36, 40, and 46. So those are all the fabric counts that we're going to be offering. Go ahead to anabellas.net, make your purchase, or go to the Etsy shop. Okay? And yes, we'll be getting a lot more fabric, you know, as things become available. We missed fiber on a whim. I believe we missed the cutoff for that. But if I can get some when I'm in Nashville, I'll get some. Okay, fun stuff coming. So Sunday this week begins Cross-Stitch Christmas Week here at Anabella's. And what that is every third week of every month, all year long, starting in January, we put aside everything that we're stitching on and we focus just on Christmas. And the reason that we do that is if you're like me and, you know, you saw when I did my kind of my whip parade, I want to have some things finished by Christmas. And I can't stitch Christmas all the time, but if I set aside 1 week a month and that's all I focus on, I put everything else aside, then it's very likely I'll have some FFOs by the end of the year. But I also have some new things that I am going to be starting, but they're from my stash, that I want to put a dent in this year. And they may not be done by the end of 2024, but at least I'll put a nice dent in them. So join the Facebook group. The link is below. Stitch along with us. It's a great group. Share your work. Let's see your progress. And you can do whatever you want. You can stitch one thing every single day, a different chart every day. You can focus on a new whip. You know, whatever you'd like to do as long as it's Christmas related. And then something really fun, you guys, is Wednesday, January 24th at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Terry and I are going to do a live chat with all of you on FlossTube. So I'm kind of nervous about it, but it should be fun. And I don't have to be nervous because you're all my stitchy friends, right? So we're just going to pop on at 7 o'clock. We're going to do a Q&A session with you. You can ask us anything you'd like. We're going to sit and stitch, and Terry's going to read comments, and you'll get to see him in person, and this should be a lot of fun. I'm just kidding. It'll be a good time. It'll be fun. So I hope you join us on Wednesday at 7 o'clock. And I'll put another notice out on social media as we get a little bit closer. But I'm looking forward to it. Very unscripted. It's going to be very unscripted. Okay, let's see what else. Told you about that. Okay, let's talk a little bit about retreats. The All Things Spring Retreat is with Anabella's, and it is in Asheville, North Carolina, May 17th through 19th. We have a few openings left, so go to crossstitchretreats.com or go to anabellas.net and be sure to sign up before those spots are filled. It's going to be a very nice weekend filled with lots of stitching. We are going to have a smalls exchange. We're going to have a phenomenal swag bag. We're going to play some games and prizes, have our famous pajama party. We've got a couple of side events planned. We're going to go to dinner at the Grove Park Inn on Thursday night for early arrivals and kind of have a cocktail party and dinner. And then once on Friday and once on Saturday, we're going to pop over to Biltmore Estate for some fun events that are going on there. Now, those are strictly optional. They are extra, but you can read about it when you go to the website and read about the All Things Spring Retreat. I'm really looking forward to it. And it's Terry's birthday on the 18th, so it'll kind of be fun. That's on Saturday night. So we'll do something for him, kind of as a surprise, maybe. We'll see. Okay. My water is way over there, and I'm not getting up. the winter pop-up retreat is February 3rd. So it's coming up fast. I can't believe it. And I'm so proud of our assistant, Kathleen, who managed to get out the swag bag that all of the winter pop-up retreats are receiving. So, you know, I don't know what I was thinking, but this is a virtual retreat. And here I am sending out swag bags to everybody. Don't know if I'm going to keep doing that in the future, though, you know. But this time and then the last time, everybody got two swag bags. They got a swag bag in the mail, and then they got a virtual swag bag. So if you are attending the winter pop-up retreat, your swag bag number one is in the mail, or you already have it. And we beg you, please do not open it. We want to save it and open it up on the day of the event. And then you will receive your second swag bag on the day of the event. Now, our guest designers are Annie from the Proper Stitcher and Diane from Silver Creek Samplers. So those are our guest designers, and we're so thrilled that they're going to be with us that day. And we have some surprise designers. So that is why I don't want you to open anything, because one of or two of the surprise designers had the charts mailed to you in that swag bag. So don't peek. And then you'll get your virtual swag bag with more designer charts and surprises on the day of the event. So looking forward to that. And then we'll do a reveal right after that, probably the end of January. We'll do a pop-up retreat reveal, and then those charts will be available at Anabella's if I decide to release them all together. And then we will have a dress rehearsal for the pop-up retreat 1 week before the event. So if you're attending the pop-up retreat, yes, we're doing a dress rehearsal, but it won't be until Wednesday or Thursday of next week. And I'll let you know the dates when I get it firmed up with the platform that we're using. She's going to do the dress rehearsal for me, which is wonderful. So I'll let you know about that. And just as a reminder, we strongly recommend that you use a desktop computer or a laptop, no iPads, no cell phones, to assure that you have the very best experience possible. And I think in our email that we sent out, we even told you what browsers would be most appropriate, so that, again, you have a really good experience and you don't run into any troubles on that day. Okay, now, mystery boxes. How fun is this? Our winter mystery box is going out today, tomorrow, the next day. Kathleen is working on getting those shipped for me. And now that I'm stranded here, might be a little slower than we thought, but we're a good week and a half ahead of schedule. So those were supposed to go out by the end of the month, and we're not at the end of the month yet. And I'm thrilled and so proud of her for all the hard work that she has done to get these boxes put together for me when I haven't been around. So those boxes will be going out, and the reveal for that will be on February 1st. So on February 1st, which is a Thursday, I believe, I'll do a winter mystery box reveal here on FlossTube. And then the very next day, the spring mystery boxes will go on sale. So that's on February 2nd. So save the date, February 2nd, spring mystery boxes go on sale. Our mystery boxes are very, very popular. They sell out very quickly. We kind of limit, you know, how much we can do as a small family-owned and operated business, you know. But, you know, we try to make enough available that as many people as want to participate can get them. And wait till you see this winter mystery box. It's my favorite one yet. So be sure to watch that sneak peek on February 1st. Not a sneak peek, but the reveal on February 1st so you can see what everybody received. Okay, one more box. The Valentine Make Finishing Fun box is also going out around the same time next week, probably. And this box is our first Make Finishing Fun box that we've done. It is Valentine themed. Plenty of time to stitch up the small Valentine charts, wink, wink, that are going to be in your Make Finishing Fun box. So that'll be going out, and you'll get an email letting you know when it's on the way. Okay, let's talk a little bit about quilting. Strawberry Lemonade by Sherry and Chelsea. The fabric pre-cuts, I believe, were sold out of almost all of them now. I think we have a few charm packs left. But the fabric by the yard and the half yard is now listed in the shop. I have to check today. I think I may have missed a bolt or two. I got to go back and recheck. But it's shipped. So as soon as it gets here, you know, probably Monday, Tuesday, I'll go ahead and start curating the Bella bundles for you. And of course, right now you can go ahead and order anything you'd like by the yard or by the half yard. We'll get that cut up and shipped right out to everybody who ordered it. And then Moda is also sending out next week Honey Bloom by Three Sisters. Honey Bloom is a beautiful collection. I'll insert a photo here. And we do have the pre-cuts available. So the pre-cuts are now in the shop. So if you would like to grab a pre-cut, go ahead. And then all of the fabric by the yard and by the half yard will be listed once I know that, you know, it's literally, you know, on the truck on the way to the shop. I'll go ahead and list all those bolts. Same thing applies. You can go ahead and buy it by the yard or by the half yard, and then we'll curate the Bella bundles as soon as it gets here. So, okay, bad news. Happy mail. I'm behind on happy mail. I'm a week and a half behind, I think. So, let's see. I think I have to do FlossTube 149 and then last week FlossTube 150. Those have to go out. And those are the ones that are, you're getting the Anabella's box. You're not getting just one chart or two charts. We decided to do something different and see if maybe you would like to receive an Anabella box filled with, you know, lots of stitching goodies, not just a chart or two. So we're just doing that on a trial basis to see how it's going. So I will get those out probably on Sunday, if the weather turns, it's supposed to warm up to the 60s next week. So as soon as it's warm enough for me to get down there, I'll get those Bella boxes out. I've pulled everything, I just haven't sent them out. So happy mail, if you're new to my channel, is just our way of saying thank you for, you know, choosing to spend some time with us. There's a million wonderful floss tubers out there. And the fact that you choose to spend a little bit of time with me and with Terry means the world to us. So I put together a Bella box, or not a Bella box, an Anabella box. Kimberbell owns Bella box. So I always have to be careful to say Anabella box. So our Anabella box is going to be just our way of saying thanks. In order to win an Anabella box, you have to be over the age of 18. You have to be a subscriber to my channel. You have to comment and like the question posed. And then you have to send an email to me at anabellasshop@gmail.com if I call your name, so that I can get your happy mail right out to you. So last week, the question was about project bags. I was wondering if you prefer vinyl fronted project bags where you can look in and see your item, or whether you prefer fabric colored project bags. And many of you, almost all of you, I would say the majority, prefer the fabric covered. But what I was surprised to see is that some folks said it's because their charts have been damaged because they stick to the vinyl. Never even would have thought of that, but I guess that's a valid point. I don't know how you get around that. Maybe put a piece of paper in between, but that kind of defeats the purpose of seeing what's inside the project bag. I'm not sure how that all works. But that was the question. And if I call your name, send that email to me, to anabellasshop@gmail.com. And the winners are Jackie Lynch, 5970, Jennifer Bluebow, Diane Brinkmeyer, and Deborah Crody. So thank you so much, ladies. I will get that Anabella box out to you early next week. So this week's question is, because we're talking about boxes, like never-ending boxes, Terry asked me about a subscription box, and I rolled my eyes to where they got, you know how when you were little and you rolled your eyes and your mom said, don't do that, they're going to get stuck in the back of your head. Well, when he said subscription box, my eyes went whoop that way. But he has some really valid points. Here's the question of the week. Would you like to have a monthly subscription box? And if you would, what would you like to have in it? So it's got to be cross stitch. We're not doing quilting yet. We'll do quilting another time. Right now we're just doing a cross stitch box. If we were to do a monthly subscription box, what would you like to see in the box? Number one. And number two, what would your price point be? Okay, so, and I'm going to give you an example. Let's say the box would be $39 to $59. What would the price point be that you would be comfortable with? And what would you like to see in the box? Maybe it's a little longer, long-winded question, but if you feel like participating, go ahead and let me know. So I guess that's it for today. I am going to get this edited, and then I'm going to sit right over there in my recliner, wait for the snow to arrive. Let's see what's behind me. This is the front porch right out here. There is a porch swing hanging right there where I spend a lot of time every spring, every summer, every fall. I live out there. I love sitting on my chair right here in my recliner. The bird feeder is at the opposite end of the porch, but when I'm in here stitching, I take the bird feeder and I carry it over and I hang it right out this window so I can see Uncle Buddy come and visit me, Buddy, which I've only seen once this winter so far. And I can watch the birds as I'm sitting to stitch. And I can see the squirrels when they're eating all my bird food. So I love that. And then in here, I have my TV over here. There's a closet right here that's filled with a few clothes, but mostly I have cross stitch and paper craft supplies in there. And then there's a long dresser on the wall right on the other side of that window there. And I have a dollhouse that my son and I built. It is, I'm a miniature enthusiast. Something new you're learning about Elaine. Back in the day, I had both an eBay store. I didn't have an Etsy store, but I had an eBay store. It was called Miniatures and Memories. And my love for miniatures has come back in a big way. I'm not gonna share it with you yet. I don't have time to do it right now, but I do have my dollhouse sitting right there and I look at it. And I open it every once in a while and play around with what's inside, but it needs a lot of work. So that's what's sitting there. This entire room is all log home wood, except for one wall, which is drywalled. And that's the wall that you saw when I sat on the floor and had my did my whip parade. I was sitting in front of my cabinets. I have a Christmas tree. It's a white flocked kind of a tree that I keep in my corner. And on that is Christmas ornaments and cross stitch smalls that I've stitched over the years. Some Judy Whitman is on there. Kind of very neglected. Didn't hang a thing on it this year. Then there's another cabinet on this other window, which looks out into the backyard. And I have a lot of essential oils and some books in that as well. So let's see, what else do I have in here? Oh, and then behind me, directly behind me, is my sewing table. There's a sewing machine on there, and where I do my quilting. I usually do it upstairs in the loft. I have another big craft room upstairs on the third floor, but I will, do some small quilting right here, sewing projects. So that's it, you guys. I really hope I get to see you back here on Wednesday for our live chat with Terry and I right here on FlossTube at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If I don't see you here on Wednesday, I hope you'll be back next Friday, same time, same place. Until then, be happy, be well. Most of all, be kind. See you later. Bye.